Kicking off another game right here. Saturday stream. Hopefully you guys stop by. Miss me dismantle S. Gibbs in Rocket League. About to play one game here with the Colts playbook in Madden on this Saturday. Try and get to the edge with the new Deion Sanders. We just showed our team on the stream. So we'll call out some of the new items we'll be working with today. Mainly the Russell Wilson at quarterback, along with possibly Derek Carr, possibly with Adrian Peterson. That's rookie Odell, and then Mike Evans, and GT Gronk, GT Herman Moore. We're going to see if Russell Wilson can run the option. We have golden ticket Tim Tebow. Defense, we'll wait till we get over there, but it's three Deion Sanders in the lineup right now. He is setting up inside zone defense. He actually might be setting up big dime A-gap. So we're pretty happy that we ran it right there. That could have been big time A-gap, the way that he brought the blitzing linebacker over. That's good inside zone D, but the way he slid the line makes me think he's trying to run the A-gap. So we're going to have to investigate and see how that takes shape during the course of this game here against our opponent, guys. Trying to let you know what I'm going to do before the snap, what I'm going to do after the snap, and hopefully it helps your guys' games get better. Once again, Colts playbook. On this looks like crossfire to me. Colts playbook on offense, double loop, same thing or similar concept, and looks like it will be some pressure from our opponent today. Russell Wilson, great animation to Dez. That's golden ticket, Dez. We just got the drag underneath. He was covering to the right. He tried to loop. Did not come in. Russell Wilson, we tried to roll. We realized the drag was open to the other side. He set his feet really quickly, which was nice. And so that was pretty good. How do you study this stuff is the question in the chat. What helps is you just play a lot of games. You start to see things. Ooh, Marcus Allen. And oh, my. Play of the day almost. Z Farrells. You start to just see the looks. I know Gibbs has been running that blitz against me a couple times. Then you confirm after that it is indeed man coverage, and you start to think, like, okay, like that's. If I'm playing a high level player, that's generally what they're going to be doing. Some type of loop, some type of maybe that man A gap. You want to see who they have. You want to see who they have at the position. Is it a fast acceleration guy? Is it a, he's in the cover two sink, so he's running the quarter street deep stuff. So we know the type of opponent we're going against, and now we just have to not let him beat us because we got to just figure out what he's doing. This is the man version. Again, you can stop the run from this, but it's difficult. And he's not going to stop it for 1 yard. We're going to get up the middle. So we're okay with that. He's going to have heavy zone coverage around the field, so it's going to be pretty hard to pass down here in the red zone. We got 10 yards to go. So we got to find a way. But, I mean, we have been able to run the ball pretty well. He looks. I think I might be able to cut to the left. I'm going to try and cut back to the left. And he did a good job diving and clicking over there. From this spot on the field, I feel good, just not. The only thing I don't feel good about down here is in this playbook. I feel like I have some plays in other formations, but in this specific playbook, so we used the Wildcat there because we really wanted to get to the edge of the defense. And I don't think he was quite ready to see that, so that worked out for us pretty nice. That's Adrian Peterson. He's our second. Halfback made a play right there. And thankfully, we didn't have to face the wrath of the blitz pressure, but we do know how to pick that up. We gave away the tip on my YouTube channel, youtube.com/zfarrells. Thanks to Stevie J. You want to block your halfback, slide protect left twice. If you see that initial big dime A-gap from the start. So those are things you want to do to pick up that pressure. We also did it by running the ball. Big hit right there from Cam Chancellor. I know I hit the buttons pretty hard. I think it's partially these buttons. This is the Elite controller. You know what? We're going to let Ray Lewis get in there today. We're going to go Clowney. We're going to go Curse here. Miller here. We're going to get Deion Sanders in the game. We're going to give Deshaun Taylor a whack. So we have three Deions in the game, which means our run defense may not be great. He's going to go gun tight, which is good because it's tough to beat. He's got Marshawn Lynch. He's going to hand off to him. And Marshawn Lynch is a tough back. Might be similar to that Steven Jackson we saw run for Stiffmeister. We're just trying to get our big dime set up, or our quarter set up, for when we want to go to zone. But right now, we're just going to run man with the Deions. He's also got Barry Sanders. I believe he could pass here. Nope. We have mostly pass rushers in this formation, so it'll be hard for us to stop the run. All right, right here where we went to this formation, we didn't get our defensive lineman in, but that's okay. He does have Vic. Let's see if he runs again. Nope. So it went to the quarter. That'll let us get a chance for Von Miller to come in the game. We'll put Curse there, and we'll keep Clowney off the left. Usually we put Clowney there, but I think the Curse actually might have more Excel. I don't think he's as fast. But good question from Jay in the chat. I don't want to get beat here deep. I tried to strafe up and get in front of that with Landon Collins, but he couldn't quite get there. What are the most important pass? I like the Cam Newton Red Baron. I'm testing out new golden tickets today. Tebow, Carr, Wilson. So none have been better than the Cam yet. But the Manziel is pretty legit. Let's see if he runs here. Just don't want to get beat deep. But I think I should be okay. Going around. He's got the drag. Good route. Good route, good route. What are the most important for pass rushers? So for pass rushers, it's power move or finesse move. Although I've heard you do want to get both, which I never thought to be true in the past. He's going to run. No, he's not. Cromartie, beat him downfield. Antonio Cromartie grabbing it, picking it, going for six. That was big for us. You saw how he went to zone coverage when I got down into the red zone. I went to zone coverage when he got down into the red zone, and you saw when he had more space, he hit that big, nice route over the Honey Badger. But there, where things kind of tightened down, Cromartie made a big play for me. Strength and block shed to stop the run. Strength and block shed to stop the run are most important. But then for pass rushers, I do find that you do want a blend of power move, finesse move a little bit. But a lot of people, initially, we thought you just wanted just power move. And at the start of the year, there's not many people with both, but the more and more Lawrence Taylors that come out, etc., you start to see the advantage. Good tackle right there. What's up, DS Lance? How you doing? But I mean, Jay, like on a. So you have outside linebackers and you have DNs, and those are guys you want the strength and stuff for. The Deion just get like. massacred? Did I pass commit? What? What was that all about? Ooh, nice run. The best pizza boneless wing? The best pizza to me? Straight cheese. Straight cheese fastball. You go to a restaurant, you say, what's your best thing that you have right here? I did pass commit here. But I do like buffalo chicken pizza, depending on where it's from. I know that's not really pizza, but otherwise green pepper onion sausage, green pepper onion chicken, some type of green pepper onion combo, if I have to get toppings on it. So, the question is, what's the best pizza place? That's the million-dollar question, but I don't think we'll ever get a firm answer to that. He could run the ball here. Yep. Good defense. I got wide right there. In 17, you'll have a force defender. That was me right there. I had to force everything back inside with Cromartie. It unfortunately let him get the first down because of the space he had, but you'll see that. Good run. He's pounding the ball. He gets the ball at half? Yeah, he gets the ball at half. So if he scores right here, he's in business. So this guy's good. He knows what he's doing. Made one bad, one tough read. Cromartie, go again, baby. Go again, Antonio Cromartie. Your second pick of the day right before the half. You're pick six in this thing all the way for the Z Farrells play of the day. Let's go. That's a huge pick before the half. Playing a good opponent right here. Cromartie's come up with two pick six, both in the red zone to kind of really give me the push that I need in this game. You know, it would have been 14-7 with his ball, and that's Cromartie doing big things right there. Great work. Z Farrell's Play of the Day nominee, guys. Make sure to follow the channel. Let me know your picks. Cromartie. Thanks, Mora. We do not want to get beat deep. We do not want to get beat deep. We do not want to get beat deep. Is there a way that I can audible without letting my opponent know? I mean, yeah, it depends on the formation, I guess. Depends the formation you're going to from where you came from. So. What's up, Novak? How you doing, man? But if you're running like a balanced set, single back ace, for example, and you flip it, like nothing happens, so that's kind of the tell. So we do have to kick off, and it is 21-0, but our opponent's definitely pretty good, so we can't take the second half easy. We're not going to just start running bunch of random plays like we might normally. In a game where we're up 21, we might normally say like, eh, I can do whatever I want. This guy's no good. But this guy is actually good. He just made one bad read, and then he made an ill-advised throw on the Vic one. But, I mean, that Cromartie bailed me out. So my playbooks right now are the Colts offense and the Pats defense. I'm okay with him running the ball due to the score. So I'm willing to let him get 10 yards because of the way the score is. And make him kind of prove he can beat me deep downfield, which I think will be tough to do with my lineup. So no problem, Novak. I hope everything's going well, man. I know how busy goes sometimes. It's not always where you want to be, but it's usually worth it in the end, hopefully. It's good stuff that's happening for you. All right, it's going to be third and short. Nice play by Deion Sanders right there. I don't want to get beat deep. You'd figure on you'd be okay here, but you never know. I'm going to look for drags across the middle. Drags across the middle, drags across the middle. Ooh, the quick out. He hung on. Nice play. Good motion. Do you pass commit an obvious? Yeah, I do hook up. I have a bad habit from last year's game where it didn't really penalize you of just doing it a lot more than I should this year. But I've stopped a good amount of doing it. But yeah, in obvious situations, like if there's no halfback in the backfield, I will pass commit, yeah. It just feels like it gives you a little bonus. So he's taken about half of the quarter to get across midfield where he's had trouble so far. So we're still okay with it. We're just trying not to get beat deep, He's going to a potential run formation. And we're good right there. So we feel good. They're able to move the chains after that last run. Vic back in shotgun formation. Complete to Calvin Johnson. TikTok, still TikToking. Do you think we'll ever set our audibles without being custom? Yes, Spartacus. I would hope in the future that that would be the case. I would let you know that that would be my feedback for the direction I'd like to see the game go. No, Raul, this guy's legit. This guy's legit. He's had two turnovers. I've only had the ball. I haven't really had the ball on offense, but his defense is pretty scary. So we sent a lot right there. Sent a couple extra guys, so that paid off for us. Second and 10, considering the quarter's three deep. I'm gonna leave Cromartie in, even though he's tired. I could put in Pat Pete, but we're going to see if Cromartie could do the magic trick one more time for us. Deep ball. That was Curse fighting for us. Good route on 3rd and 18. I think that was a curl. Or smart routed hitch, obviously. Good read right there by Antonio Gates. once again, TikTok, he's wasted, not wasted, but he's utilizing the whole quarter for this potential scoring drive, which means if we get the ball, you know, we can really apply some pressure with the way the clock is. We're not going to pass against this guy anyways due to some of the aggressive pressure he's been bringing. So, like I said, I know there's been two big plays, but not a game you want to get trapped in the fourth quarter. And not a game where you're ever really going to want to pass unless you have to. Cromartie, do it for me one more time. Cromartie, you almost got me one more. Cromartie almost got me one more right there. All right, here we go. Third and 13. After this, I got to make guacamole. It's not like a euphemism. He might run on third and 13. I really think he might run, and I did pass commit. No. All right. Bodied him up right there. Greg Lloyd. I think the Greg Lloyd's good. The strength's a little low, maybe. But I think, you know, he does a lot of what... I read somebody say he does what LT does. I gotta actually look. My team's... I feel like it's pretty much set. I know the bosses and stuff that are coming out are legit. But... he's taken the three, which I don't believe. I think you have to onside kick if you take the three right there, to be honest. Alright. So let's see what defense he comes out in. We are going to run the ball. I think he knows we're going to run the ball. He's in the chat. Which I don't mind. He may not even be watching the stream, but hopefully he knows we're going to run the ball. So let's see what his ideal defense to stop the inside zone would be. Because that's a good question, right? This guy knows the run's happening. He is going to use the double loop to try and stop it, so... too much edge game right there. He was in the double loop one more time. We've had gone to that twice and it's worked out for us both times. So we're gonna run the shovel real quick. Marcus Allen, fight. Let's go. So that was good. We ran the shovel option to the right there against the loop. The edge seems to be the spot to run against the loop. Nice D. Good defense. We got a broken tackle. So we're just kind of monitoring, guys, what's happening when people run the double loop. Let me try and pass against it with four verts. I usually don't. You saw me hit the flat to Dez earlier. I was going to try and hit it again. That's why I don't really want to pass against this guy. I think he's pretty smart. We're at the 47. Now they are special players in the NFL. Stopping the run and the speed to get outside and get the sacks on the quarterback too. Try it one more time. Yeah, between the loop and the A gap stuff, it's not a great. Got him. So yeah, that's maybe the move against it, because I know he could probably easily defend it, but to have to get your guys over there, because it stops it to the left, but if you flip it, it's pretty good. So against the loop, just block the halfback. Okay. Let's see what you got. So we only really had two offensive drives. Feel like problem, but without all the championships and money. I just feel like I run the ball a lot. That's what I mean. And without the defense. Just the run game. Just the commitment to the run game. Clowney and Curse. Yeah, sometimes the loop, I feel like it gets in, and then other times, I mean, obviously that's any blitz, but like sometimes I feel like it's a little more like volatile than other blitzes. Nice hit right there by Ray. Hey man, we're just trying it out. This guy was running it against us. We're gonna try and run it against him, see if it works. Trying it. You gotta figure if you're playing a guy who runs it himself, he might know how to stop it. Don't hate the player, hate the game, right? Is that how it is? I mean, don't create a monster. That's the thing with Gibbs. He doesn't realize. Like, I was beating him. Like, was I training? Yeah. Ew. Cam Chancellor. What are you doing? Why would you do that, Cam? Heh. Oh, apparently it's not the best blitz ever. So anyway, trying to bring some pressure. Just got to recognize it. He used play action there. Picked it up pretty easily. And, literally, the first thing I'm doing after this game is changing my team name. Who's our most recent sub? Who's our most recent subscriber? Is my new name going to be Steeltown? I feel like Steeltown's one of my guys. I feel like Steeltown actually like likes me. I don't want to go too far, but I feel like he does like me. So you have the gun doubles here, which we ran quite a bit. Is the quick audible? What's the quick audible? Yo, Gronk. Yeah, that was my bad, hold fast. I really did want to get some Halo in, but I had to relax. Just kind of had to relax. I figured you want to play more so the next day, which is today. But this is the A-gap, so ready? I was going to quickly throw it away, but then I thought I could maybe stupidly break out of the tackle, which I could not do. The Odell, I mean, Gibbs utilized him last night to devastate me with a throw in traffic, so he's pretty good. Maybe a guy you could look for on your team. The Russell Wilson? Not feeling great in the pocket. A little twitchy in the pocket, you know? I gotta go make my guacamole after this, you know? He's sending the house, I think. We got a guy wide open. Lay down. I don't know what happened right there. I gotta learn Mike Scrape, or not Mike Scrape. I gotta learn Crossfire from Big Dime. I don't know, really know how to do it. Yeah, I mean, overall, at this point in the game, the players do the work for you. So, that was a good game right there. Like I said, my opponent deserves the hat tip. Antonio Cromartie made some nice plays for me. That was kind of the real difference in the game. We didn't really have the ball at all on offense. Let me see. I want to see the time of possession in that game. Because he mainly drove it. We had a really nice drive to start where we ran the rock pretty well. Yeah, so we had double our time of possession, basically. And then we got the two pick sixes, so we never went back on offense. Russell Wilson was 4 for 4, which we were really 2 for 2. But we got sacked a couple times. And then running-wise, the Wildcat helped us in a couple situations, but Marcus Allen was 8 for 69. That was good. And the shovel option really bailed us out when he switched over to the loop. So, yeah, that was huge. If we go back and look at Cromartie. Yeah, so this was just before the half. It was 14-0, and he was trying to make it 14-7. We did a good job taking away this route in the middle of the field. We kind of ran into the guy and took the read away. And then we bailed. Actually, we didn't. We started to bail. He playmakered the guy. We sent Clowney, so he had to throw. He threw back foot across his body. And Cromartie came in, got it, and went. So that was huge. This was probably his best pass play of the day. This is kind of the one weakness of the Cover 2 sync. I do like the Honey Badger there. But I'm thinking, if the Honey Badger's a little bit taller, do you guys think he makes this play? If I put Cam Chancellor here, do you think he maybe could make that? I guess that's kind of the million-dollar question, because that's really the only place I get beat in this defense, and it takes a lot. It takes, you need the blocking, the routes, the patience. You need me not, like, you need a lot to get that route there, but it is kind of the one weak spot of that defense. Thankfully, when the field got tightened down in zone coverage, we were able to make the play. So Cromartie again there. Offensively, we had the drag underneath to Dez. That helped us, as the pressure didn't come in. But look at Russell Wilson here. I felt good about that. Like that, as we rolled, we saw that the drag was open, and we knew we had to get rid of the ball quick. That quick pivot and on throw target was clutch for us. And then we continued just to kind of run the ball. We had a nice juke, a nice stiff arm that we performed right there, which you don't really see a ton of. And that was a good play. So, anyway, guys, that's it for the stream for right now. I got to go make some guacamole. If you liked it, give the channel a follow. We'll be back later today with some more games. We got to get on for some Halo 5 this weekend. That's like our one goal. And if you're watching on YouTube, a little replay, make sure to subscribe to the channel. All right, Z Farls, signing out.